This program is brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Mosaic, a daily news program from Link TV, presents a selection of news reports from independent and state-controlled broadcasters from throughout the Middle East.
The Iraqi authorities have intensified security measures by enforcing a curfew and halting traffic to avoid any possible attacks by booby-trap vehicles during the local elections, which will begin tomorrow. The election campaigns, which have been going on for 7 weeks, will also end.
A few hours before the provisional elections in Iraq began, competition increased between political parties and candidates. Although election campaigns have stopped, as was called for by High Elections Committee, it seemed clear that some parties had access to more funding, which enabled them to have better campaigns. Iraqis are voting in 14 provinces out of 18 total Iraqi provinces. The three Kurdish provinces and the Kirkuk province have been excluded, since the parliament failed to adopt an election law that can accommodate the diverse population there. محافظة كركوك المتنازع عليها بعد إخفاق مجلس النواب في اعتماد قانون انتخابي يلائم. More than 14,000 candidates are competing for 440 provisional council seats. Baghdad's streets, alleys, squares, and other Iraqi cities are filled with posters of different candidates and election slogans for independent and party candidates. وساحاتها وأزقتها وكذلك المدن العراقية الأخرى امتلأت بصور المرشحين و. Iraqi security agencies have implemented a special security plan for the elections and have tightened security measures in Iraqi cities.
وشهدت المدن العراقية إجراءات أمنية مشددة وفق خطة أمنية.
The plan called for enforcing a curfew for 3 nights during the elections, closing the borders between different Iraqi provinces in addition to international borders by land, sea and air, and banning anyone from carrying weapons except for the Iraqi government.
وإغلاق الحدود العراقية البرية والجوية والبحرية، منع حمل السلاح وحصر السلاح بالقوات الأمنية.
However, the security plan could not stop some security breaches. Three candidates in Baghdad, Mosul, and Diyala were assassinated.
في كل من بغداد والموصل وديالا. وللمرة الأولى منذ خوض العراق.
Unlike the elections of January and December in 2005, the Anbar province in western Iraq witnessed a high turnout.
في نفس العام تشهد محافظة الأنبار غرب العراق زخما وتجاوبا انتخابيا.
During the 2005 elections, the Sunnis boycotted the elections. At the time, the Anbar province was controlled by Al-Qaeda.
في الانتخابات الثانية.
We are helping the security forces to carry out their mission. The candidates are competing in a legitimate way in Anbar. All of the candidates are citizens of this country, and people will vote for those who have a record of achievement.
Political experts are betting that these elections will change the political map in Iraq if they are held properly. Hadir El Rubai, Al Arabiya.
ومع اقتراب انتخابات مجالس المحافظات التي ستجرى في العراق نهاية هذا.
The role of Iraqi women in tomorrow's provisional elections is controversial. Some believe that there are not enough women to fill 1/4 of the council seats, which were designated to women. Others, however, believe that women were not given leadership positions to begin with, and say that this is the reason behind the failure in the councils.
في تلك المجالس.
استطاعت الديمقراطية الجديدة في العراق.
After the new democracy in the new Iraq, many political seats were designated for women. Perhaps the number of seats allocated to women in Iraq exceeds that of any other democratic country in the world. 1/4 of the provisional council seats in the current elections were designated for women. The question is, have women who were elected in the past fulfilled voters' expectations?
ما هو مطلوب منها
دور المرأة العراقية في الانتخابات العامة في العراق دور إيجابي جدا.
The role of Iraqi women in the local elections is very positive. Some, however, think that Iraqi women in the parliament and those holding seats in the provisional council did not fulfill voters' expectations.
ما كان متوقع منهم.
برلمانيات أخريات أشرنا إلى وجود مخاوف أمنية.
Other female parliament members expressed security concerns and said many women refrained from running in these elections due to these concerns. This comes despite news reports about security improvements. These security concerns explain why some political parties could not find a sufficient number of qualified women to represent them in the elections. As a result, some believe that women who lack political experience are running in the elections.
Women in the parliament and provisional councils played a key role in protecting the structure of these councils. They also helped in creating consistency in holding provisional council meetings and improved their performance. They also played a role in communicating with the public.
Another achievement that can be claimed by women is the fact that they have not been involved in corruption, which is widespread in Iraq. According to the International Transparency Organization, Iraq has become the most corrupt country in the world.
Women have shown that they are qualified to hold public office, especially when they have proven that they are more transparent than their male counterparts in Iraq. There have been no women that have been involved in administrative and financial corruption, and this is a strength for the women.
However, some disagree with this view. They believe that women have not been involved in administrative corruption simply because they have not been given positions where they are in charge of money. Men have manipulated all of these positions. Those who are opposed to the political process say that the numbers of seats allocated to women or men does not mean anything because they do not have much control over things. The Iraqi Prime Minister, however, said that Iraq gained its sovereignty when the Green Zone was handed over to the Iraqis in the beginning of this year.
قال الجيش الأمريكي إن عدد حالات الانتحار بين جنوده.
U.S. Armed Services said that suicide rates among its soldiers in 2008 reached 128 cases. This is a record high since they began to track soldier suicide rates in 1980. Suicide rates of U.S. soldiers have been increasing steadily since the beginning of the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq.
أرقام هي الأعلى منذ أن بدأ رصد معدلات الانتحار بين جنوده. هكذا قيم الجيش الأمريكي حالات الانتحار.
Suicide rates are at an all-time high since such statistics began being tracked. This is how the U.S. military evaluated suicide cases among its soldiers in 2008. 128 suicide cases have been confirmed, in addition to another 15 suspected suicide cases, which are under investigation. The numbers in 2008 jumped by 11% compared to the previous year, with 115 reported cases of suicide, which was a record number at that time. There's been a continuous increase in suicides since the beginning of the U.S. wars on Afghanistan and Iraq.
هذا الارتفاع المضطرد كان بمثابة جرس إنذار للمسؤولين الأمريكيين.
This steady increase has alarmed U.S. officials. The Army often attributes suicide cases to personal reasons, but for the first time, the number of suicides among soldiers has exceeded the suicide rate of U.S. civilians. This prompted Army officials to re-evaluate the problem and to examine the psychological effects of the continuous wars in Iraq and Afghanistan on U.S. soldiers.
الآثار النفسية الناتجة عن الحرب المستمرة في العراق وأفغانستان على الجنود الأمريكيين. فقد كشف الجيش عن حملة جديدة.
The Army revealed a new campaign to combat this trend of suicides. It will be led by the Army's Vice Chief of Staff and will include special instructions and training programs. The Army is also launching a $50 million research study to examine suicide and suicidal behavior. It's not the first campaign to combat suicide.
هذه ليست المرة الأولى التي يعلن فيها عن حملات لمكافحة الانتحار. فمن بين أهداف الجهود الجديدة.
However, a new objective of this campaign is to define the reasons for the ineffectiveness of previous programs. What's new is the acknowledgement that war itself might be a factor in this increase. According to the latest study, 35% of suicide cases took place after returning from combat missions, while 30% involved soldiers on the battlefield.
و30% كانت لجنود في الميدان.
We'll be right back. Tension is once again straining the ties between Sudan and Chad. The Minister of Information and Communication, Kamal Obeid, accused Chad of providing supplies to the Justice and Equality Movement, which is one of the armed movements in the Darfur region.
Relations between these two neighboring countries became tense after Chad's earlier accusation that Sudan supported a new coalition rebelling against the government of N'Djamena.
Tension and reciprocal accusations are straining the ties between Sudan and Chad once again. Khartoum said that it acquired what it called irrefutable evidence of Chad's involvement in the military escalation led by the Justice and Equality Movement in the Darfur region.
The Sudanese government tried all possible means to stop the situation from reaching this degree of tension. However, we were unable to convince the government of Chad to desist from reneging on its promises and commitments. This is why we had to talk about this issue and use suitable methods to stop Chad's assault on Sudanese nationals and civilians.
Violence has continued in the Darfur region, promising dire repercussions. The groups that signed on the Abuja peace agreement are concerned that the equality and justice movement will undermine their influence in the region. They fear that the struggle will turn into an internal battle between the movements and splinter the movement.
We are talking about national unity. As groups that signed on the peace agreement, the first thing is that we completely condemn this struggle. This struggle will lead to fighting between the people of Darfur themselves. Right now, military policy is what will lead to political discourse.
The Sudanese political powers have continued to take action regarding the International Criminal Tribunal. Politicians and thinkers called for a legal solution that would help the country avoid possible anguish caused by the international community.
We suggest the establishment of a mixed court composed of Sudanese judges whose independent thinking, science, and qualifications cannot be refuted. Those people would be the nucleus. They would also be joined by Arab and African judges to form a specialized court.
As for the political activities in Khartoum, the Russian envoy in Sudan concluded his visit by meeting President Bashir. He asked the international community to adopt what he called a balanced attitude with Sudan.
The choice between justice and peace is a difficult one, and choosing between them might be wrong. A more balanced approach might render better results.
Between the international debates and the international proceedings, all options remain open in regards to Darfur and the International Criminal Tribunal. Meanwhile, the Sudanese street is on alert for what tomorrow may bring. Fayez Alzaki, Nile TV, Egypt News Channel, Khartoum.
The war on Gaza, which angered Erdogan, was the focal point in the talks by George Mitchell, the U.S. envoy to the Middle East in Ramallah. Mitchell brought a U.S. promise to work on reaching a permanent peace. After meeting Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas, Mitchell affirmed Washington's commitment to supporting two states living side by side in peace and security. During the visit by the U.S. envoy, Israeli planes continued to launch air raids on Gaza. Two rockets were also launched from Gaza towards Israel. Fatma Al-Tawil reports.
The U.S. envoy to the Middle East, George Mitchell, smiled optimistically outside the headquarters of the Palestinian president in Ramallah. This smile might be due to the large initiative he is bringing with him to revitalize peace in the Middle East. His meeting with Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas lasted 90 minutes, after which Mitchell called for securing a permanent ceasefire in Gaza.
It's important من المهم تعزيز
It is important to consolidate a sustainable and durable ceasefire, and we encourage continuing efforts in that regard. To be successful in preventing the illicit trafficking of arms into Gaza, there must be a mechanism to allow the flow of legal goods, and that should be with the participation of the Palestinian Authority.
Political attempts don't seem to have succeeded in making the truth stick in Gaza or at its border. Two rockets were launched towards Israel in response to an Israeli raid on southern Gaza and another Israeli strike that injured about 22 Palestinians. Between political maneuvers and a fragile ceasefire, the only constant in Gaza is destruction that's waiting for the rebuilding funds to arrive. Meanwhile, the children in Gaza continue to sing, even if it's over the rubble of their homes.
The European Union announced a plan to give 58 million euros in support of Gaza and demanded that Israel allow humanitarian teams to enter into Gaza. Luis Michel, the European Commissioner for Development and Humanitarian Aid, said that the destruction in Gaza is abominable.
The Brussels conference, which was held to discuss ways to support the people of Gaza, coincided with a visit of Luis Michel, the European Commissioner for the Development and Humanitarian Aid, to Gaza. The European Union announced a $58 million plan to aid the Palestinian people. Michel also demanded that Israel open the Gaza crossing so food and medical supplies can reach the people there. After touring Gaza, he said that the destruction in Gaza is abominable and that the reconstruction will be extremely difficult. Michel condemned the Israeli aggression.
This is one of the biggest cases of human rights violations. There is no single reason that justifies this military operation, which targeted civilian populations who do not play a role in the military struggle.
20 million dollars will be given to the West Bank. The money will be used to secure necessary aid pertaining to food, water, and building sewage systems and shelters. Michel said the European Union will not have a dialogue with Hamas and held the movement partially responsible.
It is true I hold Israel responsible, but I also accuse Hamas of being responsible for what happened here.
Before leaving Gaza, Michel said that it is likely that the European Union will allocate more urgent funds in the next few days due to the dire situation in Gaza.
In cooperation with the United Nations Relief and Works Agency, UNRWA, the Palestinian National Campaign for Relieving Gaza, and the Minister of the Economy have provided new shipments of food and medical supplies for the people in Gaza. The supplies will be distributed among the families that need them in Gaza. The Palestinian National Campaign for Relieving Gaza continues to receive donations to support the people in Gaza.
أظهرت صور مسجلة من قطاع غزة عملية إطلاق نار متعمد على ساق أحد المواطنين في تسجيل يوثق
Video images from Gaza show that Hamas deliberately shot a man in the leg. The video documents Hamas forces shooting a large number of citizens. These images are of the citizen Aif Saad Abyed from the Preventative Security Forces and who is also a member of the Fatah organization in the Sheikh Ridwan area. On Monday, elements from Hamas kidnapped and assaulted him. He was shot in the leg and left to bleed. He was forced to crawl before he was able to finally get to the Shifa hospital in Gaza.
كشفت صحيفة هآرتس الإسرائيلية أن الحاخام الأول في الحاخامية العسكرية لجيش الاحتلال العميد أفي رونتسيكي.
The Israeli Haaretz newspaper revealed that the chief rabbi of the Israeli occupation forces, Avi Ronziki, distributed religious pamphlets to the soldiers before embarking on the aggression in Gaza, telling them to deal with the Palestinian civilians harshly. Ronziki also gave inciting speeches to most of the occupation soldiers, calling on them to use brutality with the Palestinian civilians. He said that there is no such thing as a Palestinian civilian. Ronziki also brought a number of the most extremist Israeli rabbis to give inciting speeches, including Rabbi Shmuel Eliyahu, who gave a religious decree saying that it is okay to kill Palestinian women and children. According to the Haaretz newspaper, many of the Israeli soldiers were influenced by these incitements and acted accordingly.
The children of Gaza have left their school desks before graduating. They were martyred at an early age. A special report by Nihal Sayed.
Bashar used to sit here, Imad over here, and Abed al-Rahman right there. They are all gone, and their voices calling on the teacher to answer a question can no longer be heard. These desks are now empty because of the Israeli attacks that killed these students. This has become a painful memory in the minds of their classmates, while they still can't believe that their classmates are gone.
I can't believe that he was martyred. He was just going to check on his mom. He left his house and went to Deir al-Balah. On his way, he was martyred. How is this possible? I cannot imagine or believe that he was martyred. On the day I came back to school, I ran away when I did not find him.
Hussam was unable to control his emotions and finish the conversation with me about his classmate, who is now gone and he will no longer be able to see him. The memories in the classroom are painful to him, but he is not alone because a lot of other students here live in the same misery. They lost their classmates who used to sit on desks that are now empty due to the crazy Israeli war that killed their childhood and dreams.
وأحلامهم.
أنا نفسي أخذ حريتي زي باقي كل العالم أطفالهم أخذوا حريتهم في التعليم.
I just want to have my freedom like the rest of the people in the world. Children all around the world can get their education except for the children in Gaza. All I want is my education and a home. Other than that, I don't want anything else. In all other countries, children have an education and freedom, but not the children in Gaza. We want an education and freedom. We children have rights, and we want to have our rights as children.
Do you believe that she is only a child? Everything that she has gone through has made her grow up before her time. This is the situation of the children in Gaza because the occupation's forces destroyed their homes and evicted them. They are now living in shelters. Here they are in the Jabalia Service Center. They do not have food or clothes besides the little that they can get their hands on. The war is still raging. This child, Shireen, and her mother are crying because of the hard situation they are living in.
We want to have clothes like other children. We need gas. We're always hungry and we feel like orphans. We are wearing dirty clothes. We never do anything. We want to go to school like other children.
We are so tired. I swear to God, we are tired. We do not want war anymore. We just want someone to feel with us. Please, people, feel with us. We had enough. We are tired. We are really tired. Our children are tired. They are suffering psychologically and they can't go to school. I need a safe home.
As for Bissan, you can no longer see her baby face, and now she just appears sad and gloomy. The only thing she wants is for her father to come back and hug her between his arms. The question here is he still alive, or did he die like all the others who've passed away?
We can't find my dad. I miss my dad.
I don't know where he is. We can't find him anywhere.
From the Gaza Strip, Nihal Sayed, New TV.
Turkey's Prime Minister Erdogan spars with Israeli President Peres in Davos. Why is Erdogan hailed as a hero by Arabs? And will this affect Turkey's role as a mediator in the Middle East? Answers to these questions and more on Link TV's Mosaic Intelligence Report.
A hero's welcome for Turkey's prime minister.
The new hero of the Arab street is Turkish Prime Minister Recep Tayyip Erdogan. A short while ago, it was U.S. arch enemy Hugo Chavez, the Venezuelan president who recently expelled the Israeli ambassador. More than 5,000 people, many waving Palestinian and Turkish flags, greeted Recep Tayyip Erdogan after his airplane touched down in Istanbul on Friday. A few hours earlier, the Turkish prime minister had stunned the audience in Davos, Switzerland, when he walked out of a televised debate with Israeli President Shimon Peres after the moderator refused to allow him to rebut Peres' justification about Israel's war on Gaza.
I want to understand, why did they fight rockets against us? What for? There was not any siege against Gaza.
Before storming out, Erdogan told Shimon Peres,
"Biliyorum ki sesinin bu kadar çok yüksek çıkması,
the reason why your voice is so loud is because you must be feeling guilty. When it comes to killing, you Israelis know a lot."
During the past 24 hours, Arab satellite television networks have been abuzz with this story, as if other issues presented at the annual meeting of World Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland, did not matter.
I am not a tribal leader. I am a leader of Turkey. I did what I was supposed to do, and I would do the same if circumstances require it.
His position was very strong and brought honor to Turkey.
Arab masses have been looking for a champion since the fracture between Arab countries over convening a summit on Gaza and the disconnect between them and their leaders, who they believe failed to react to Israel's fiercest attacks on the mostly civilian population in the Gaza Strip. The conflict in Gaza underscored the Arab divide between those allied with Egypt and Saudi Arabia on one side and with Syria and Qatar on the other. In contrast, since the war on Gaza began, Erdogan has openly and strongly blasted Israel. He called on it to be barred from the United Nations, accused it of using white phosphorus against Gaza civilians, and charged it with other inhuman actions which would bring it to self-destruction. Allah will sooner or later punish those who transgress the rights of innocents, he said. Israel's President Shimon Peres told reporters at a press conference in Davos that there is no conflict and that we respect Turkey, Israel's closest Muslim ally in the Middle East. He said bilateral relations with Turkey will remain as they are and that Turkey offers a moderate alternative in the Muslim world. However, relations between Turkey and Israel have soured. Istanbul has witnessed one of the largest anti-Israel demonstrations in the world, and Israeli media, most notably the Jerusalem Post, has accused Erdogan of encouraging expressions of anti-Semitic sentiments in his country. Meanwhile, it's been almost 2 weeks since Israel has withdrawn its forces from Gaza, and Arab countries are still squabbling over aid to Gaza. Hamas has been calling for an alternative leadership to the Palestinian cause. The people in Gaza are suffering from a humanitarian crisis. But amidst all this, Arabs have found a new hero, at least for a week or two. I'm Jamal Dejani for the Mosaic Intelligence Report. To learn more about this program or to share your thoughts, visit us at linktv.org/mir. You can also visit my blog at the Huffington Post.
Get more news about the Middle East online at linktv.org/mosaic. The Mosaic webpage offers a complete archive of Mosaic programs, program transcripts, the Mosaic video podcast, and the Mosaic Intelligence Report, a weekly analysis of the hottest stories from the Middle East. The views expressed on Mosaic are those of the participating broadcasters, not Link TV or its sponsors. The production of Mosaic is made possible with the support of viewers like you. Thank you. This program was brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. television network devoted to global and national news with uncompromising documentaries and diverse cultural programs. Programs which connect you to the world.